Tennessee after the break. Thank you, sir. A field goal separates these two teams as we come back for this second half.
Graham Gano set to kick off.
It'll be Falcons football, and they trail here as we get back underway on EA Sports. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Atlanta offense out there for their next drive. And that last touchdown drive, they had very balanced. How key is that balance?
It's huge, because most of the times we talk about balance is run, pass, almost 50-50. But most of the times we talk about offensive coaches, they say balance is we do what we want when we want to. And that means that they're ahead of the defense, keeping them on their heels.
Yeah, they imposed their will on that last drive. Looking to throw again on second down. He's going to have to hook up to Gage. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains.
Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
Hayden Hurst, former first-round pick, the intended target, but it's going to be second down. Smith, and he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 12 yards there and a first down. His first carry of their second drive, pretty solid. And of course, remember back to their first drive, really strong throughout that one.
Not only is he getting good blocking up front, but how about his vision to find the holes? And he's seeing things before they even open and hurtling through them.
Now throwing on first down and completing it. And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right of the yard.
Well, if you do read man coverage, Brandon, the drag route's a pretty good one to run against it, because you're running away from people on it.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Ryan.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
This is third and one, very likely four down territory, even if they don't get it, though. Here's Ryan. And that is incomplete. He had a defender right there with him to force that to the ground. And fourth down now coming up.
Normally, being a big-bodied receiver plays to their advantage downfield. Go up and make the catch, take the hit, and pick up yardage. But in this case, the hit was timed really well and popped it free from his grasp.
Field goal would have been a decent length at 55 yards. They keep the kicking unit on the sideline. They're going for it. They're going on fourth down. It's Ryan. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. A defensive breakdown allows a pickup of 16 on fourth down. A first down carry for Smith. And he's got four down inside the 20 to the 18. Ball carrier.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a game, considering the blitz that they just had against them.
The run got four. Now they deal with a second and six. Again, it's Smith. It's a 10-yard gain there to set him up first and goal.
The more football I watch, the more I want to check and see if teams are going to panic when they're down on the scoreboard. And this team has shown no signs of doing that. A lot of the time, they come out after the half. Things haven't worked so well in the first go-round. They want to throw the football like crazy. But the way they open up throwing the ball is to run it, and they've run it well here. there to start the second half.
That's a gain of 7, and we'll leave them with second and goal coming up.
And, Brad, they went to a nickel defense, and that's a surprise this close to the goal line, because ordinarily you use the back end of the end zone, the sidelines, as extra defenders, and you want bigger people on the field to try and help against the run.
Have retaken the lead. An out route there for the score. A quick out route there for the score.
Hey, you're not really surveying the defense on this one. You're just counting on timing, making this play happen. 1-2, ball's out of his hands. Knows where he's going, just puts it to the...
Sterling Hoffrichter to kick off for the Falcons.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Pettis now on the return. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line.
The Giants take over first and 10 at their own 29-yard line.
Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. They trail offense, first time to touch the ball in quarter 3, and we'll see what they can do.
I can't wait to see what they have planned, because some teams script to start a half. Other teams just go, okay, these are the sequence of plays we want to run. These things worked well for us. And sometimes they throw in that big chunk play right away.
Shocker.
Try and get after them early and try and create a big play to give themselves some momentum.
See what they have up their sleeve. Oh, he dropped it. They were looking for him in the middle third. He couldn't catch it. Now third down.
Incomplete. It's third.
They come up now, 3rd and 5, following the incomplete pass.
Good go.
Operating from the gun, Jones. And Ingram hauls it in. And he will have a Giants first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. First down Giants, Jones to Ingram. Back now in Atlanta. It's been a very hotly contested game to this point. Just a field goal separating these two teams as we get set for the fourth quarter. Taken down at the 48 for a pickup of 2 yards.
Tackle made.
Foyasade Aluakon made the tackle there from his safety position.
Brings up 2nd and 8.
The last run got a couple. Here's 2nd and 8. Of a full 3 yards there, and it also brings up 3rd down. This out to Barkley, complete. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. Great way to convert on 3rd down there. 21 yards the play. From Falcon territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 34. On 1st down, Barkley. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Another nice gain, 13 yards that time, and another 1st down.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
Keep it with Barkley on 1st down. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8. Barkley 2nd and 2.
Ball carrier.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down 4th quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy. system. And he'll only get a yard to bring up third and one. They'll give him a yard on the play. And just like that, it's third down. Three points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth. So it's Giants football here as we welcome you back. This is third and two, maybe the biggest play in this football game. Crusher there as it's intercepted. Picked up by Keanu Neal. And he returns it up just shy of the 20 to the 19-yard line.
Well, I don't think we'll have to look very hard to find our play of the game. That was an absolutely monstrous big play right there. Backs to the wall. The offense has it in the red zone, driving for the winning score. And he says, not on my watch. And that is one happy bunch on the sidelines.
About set to begin their next drive, the Falcons offense at the line. And this game not quite over yet. And we'll likely see them take all three timeouts defensively, so they can't just kneel this one out. They're going to have to try to run a few plays.
You're exactly right. They've got to get a first down and make them use up all their timeouts in order to feel like they have this one in hand.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Ryan's going to throw it. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's upended after a gain of four up to the 25-yard line.
Gain of four.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go because he might wander into some tough coverage.
And it looks like we've got a dime set here defensively. Six DBs in the game. Try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And this will be a Falcons first down as they take this up to about the 33-yard line. Now the Giants will use the second of their three timeouts as they get the stoppage with just over a minute to go in the game. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up first and 10. On the carry, here's Smith. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. And how about in the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
Certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Smith. And it pushes way forward to about the 32. The Giants going to burn their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 18 seconds remaining.
Third and 10.
Down, ready, 25.
this one up.